again.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Volume, Victor.
الفوليوم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والشكر لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. I'm just gonna give you a little hint about what I'm planning to say maybe for the next few weeks. Okay. If you guys remember, like over a year ago, we talked about عظمت الله, تفكر في خلق الله, and we start talking about outer space and all the planets and all of that stuff. And I felt that was a really nice thing, and it's just a change of gear. This is still related to what we're having here in our masjid. Okay, this is actually. التفكر في خلق الله. This is actually عبادة. Okay, we were ordered to think about it and see how great is عظمة الله and how blessed we are in the planet we are living on. Okay, unfortunately, our patience didn't allow us to listen more and more and more, so we cut it down. So if you would like that, I can continue. I can give you another session about it. Okay. And we'll talk about our solar system, because this is a system we know most about it, okay? And this is a system which we are more interested in, okay? Because it is surrounding us, okay? And so probably maybe in a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks, I already prepared something, but I would like to supplement it with more information. I brought an image here, okay? Which showing you the sun and all the planets in its solar system. Okay, so probably you can talk about each one individually.
Yeah.
So anyway, I mean, if you guys would like to, if you can devote like maybe 45 minutes or something like that, I have to bring some markers and we can sit down, we can make a U-turn, all of us, and we look at this board and we can talk about it. So probably would say maybe in 2 weeks we can have that. Yes. Would you like? Would you like to have that stuff?
Really, of course.
Okay, yeah. That would be great. Okay.
Inshallah.
And we'll send you some pictures through email.
Please.
Because I know you're gonna be busy somewhere else.
We'll be okay.
Inshallah. So let's do that. Inshallah. Today I'm gonna talk about something. It might look a little bit different than what we've been talking about, but it is, again, it's within our belief and our, our ibadah. Okay. Let me start asking questions. Okay, how many of us have been in a law of court, or court of law, I'm sorry, in a court of law? Okay, you don't have to be as a criminal. You could be as a defendant. You could be as a witness. You could be just watching.
As a victim too.
As a victim too. Could be in jury duty. Okay.
Yeah.
So we've been. I mean, lots of us seen that. Okay, and we saw the things which are going on in the court of law. Okay, and we see the judges and we see the lawyers, the plaintiff and the defendant. And we see witnesses coming in, witnesses coming out, and talking about things, and documents coming in, and documents coming out, And the bottom line, it is really, the verdict is rather just, okay? But you might feel that it's not really perfectly just, okay? There are shortcomings in there, okay? The lawyers might play a little bit and bring some documents which you're not really trusting.
Liars. Liars?
Lawyers.
Liars.
Oh, the lawyers aren't liars and stuff like that. Okay. So the perfection in our worldly court flow, okay, is not really complete. It's not really 100%. There are all those shortcomings. Okay. But this is the court we witnessed in here. It's the court we know about it. But is there another court we're going to be all facing later on?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. This is the court. Okay. When we really face it, our judge is going to be Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. He's going to be our judge. The ultimate perfection, the ultimate justice. Okay. And you cannot really say anything. No defects whatsoever. This is the court of law in the day of judgment. So let's see what is there and try to think about what was in our life, okay, and see the comparison between both of them. Okay? So anyway, so what do we see? What do we hear? What do think about it in that day when we are facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah with his ultimate justice is really talking to us and judging us. Okay? So all the documents coming in that day, I'm gonna talk about the day, the court of Allah. Alright? So all the documents coming in that day are not secret. It's known. Okay? Who said so? Al Quran said so. Al Quran said, وَكُلُّ إِنسَانٍ أَخْرَجْنَا وَكُلُّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَا طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا. This is Surah Al-Isra, verse 13. Okay, what does it mean? Okay, talking about the documents. Everybody is gonna bring documents showing what you have done in public, okay? Documents, okay? And you were responsible for document, because those are your deeds. This is what you have done. Yes.
If I do Tawbah, would I still my documents in public?
Huh?
If I have done Tawbah.
Yeah.
Your documents still.
There is something in public, and there is something you're gonna be. In God will protect you by his veil. He's gonna spare you. Okay. He doesn't wanna. I mean, if you're a really good person, he's not gonna really. يفضحك يعني I don't know what يفضحك means what I don't know
expose
okay,
expose.
Okay.
Expose.
Huh? Yeah expose. it's not gonna expose you okay
if he covers you in dunya he will not show your shame to be
your sense in
yes historic في الآخر معروف
إن شاء الله okay so first thing الملفات غير سرية it's not really secret documents in that day second thing الحضور تحت حراسة مشددة. So you're gonna be coming into, meeting Allah. سينادي المنادين هلوما فلان ابن فلان ده الملائكة is gonna هلوما للعرض على الجبار.
You're gonna be, two angels.
Yeah. So you're gonna be called in among all the billions of people sitting there. Okay. You're gonna be called in by the name and the. And you're gonna be so scared, you know. I mean, you're not gonna stand up right away, but angels will know you from all of those things by the looking at your face, because you're gonna be trembling and you're gonna be facing Allah, you're gonna be talking to him, okay? So al-hudur tahta harasat mushaddada. And this is actually it's also testified by verses from the Quran. وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. Everybody is coming with plain translation with a driver and a witness. Okay, so driver is actually like
angel.
Yeah. Okay,
drive and, you to the land of the gathering.
Yeah, and the shaheed is your documents with you. It's gonna be there. Okay, so that's gonna be, and this is actually Surah Qaf, yes. Verse number 21. I have to go a little bit faster, okay? Next thing is, injustice is impossible in that day. الظلم مستحيل. Impossible to be unjustly treated.
Yes.
Why? Because Allah is the one who's treating you. There's no grain of injustice you're going to be there, okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, وَمَا أَنَا ظَلَّامٌ للعبيد. I am not really unjust for my servants. وما أنا بظلام للعبيد. Okay, and that's Surah Qaf, also number 29. Okay, the other thing is, ليس هناك محامي للدفاع. Nobody there as a defense lawyer. Okay, you defend yourself. Okay. Okay. The lawyers really. That's it.
Public defendant.
You can hire public defendant if you want.
Yeah, you can. The Quran will be your mahil. Can be your attorney.
That's what the mark.
Huh?
That's the mark to defend you.
The Quran will defend you. Mahil musaddaq. Attorney and the honest attorney.
The Quran will defend you, all your good deeds.
And your
fast,
yeah.
They will defend you.
Intercede for you.
Sure. Everything, you know. Your friend, you know, I mean, not your friend. Your friend can intercede to you.
Yes, yes, but later, not in
later on. That's yeah. later on. After yeah. you,
your friend, your mu'mineen, you'll get somehow some kind of.
Huh?
How about the Prophet?
Well, the Prophets, the Prophets.
This is the first intercession.
That's the first intercession, okay. All the Prophets will be reluctant to defend, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to say ana laha, and he will defend his ummah first, okay?
Yeah.
Right? And so there are no defense lawyers there. And the Quran says, اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا.
Yes.
Your book is your testimony, okay? Your book, whatever is good and whatever is bad in it. This is what, you don't need anybody to talk on your behalf, no go-between. It's you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Mm.
Okay? Second thing, لا رشوة ولا وساطة. No bribery. No go-betweens. It's only you. It's only you and subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. And that's the day. Money and children and wealth and your history is not going to help
no
you.
No check, doctor.
your how much you had in the bank, and you cannot really write a check just to bail yourself out. No.
Somebody is cousin.
Even if you take all the money with you when you die, okay, if you have everything with you, you cannot really pay it over there. It's not really acceptable there. It's a different money.
Different coins
there. Yeah, it's a different thing.
Credit card?
Huh?
Credit card?
I don't know. Sometimes the machine is not working over there. Okay, so sometimes.
You know, doctor, that lady, her husband, he wrote in his will, and give me all of my money with me in the grave.
Yeah.
And his wife, she was so sad. How can you take the money? What would it be? And she was asking her friend what he should do. She said, just write a check for him.
Write a check, and she put it in his grave with
it.
With all the money, he had. She didn't cheat him, you know. Okay, so there's no go-between, and there's no bribery. You can't bribe him.
Yes.
And then that's actually Surah Shu'ara, number 88. And then لا اختلاط ولا تشابه في الأسماء. There's no confusion about the names. Oh, your name is this one. The fourth name is not the same like what you have in your ID and stuff like that. Somebody fell into that problem before. Okay, it's not really matching. Oh, that's God who knows everybody, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, there is no confusion about you. You means you. Okay, and there's no argument about that.
وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردة.
Yeah.
Allah numbered us and He count us. We're gonna be numbered in the day of judgment. قد أحصاهم وعدهم عدا.
And also Allah said, وما كان ربك نسيا.
نعم.
He's not gonna forget about that. And that's Surah Maryam.
Yes.
Okay. Then you're gonna be handed your verdict in your hand. استلام الحكم باليد. You're gonna take your verdict by your hand. Okay. And God said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمْقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَ. How lucky you are when you get your book with your right hand. This is a good sign. You should really be happy that you're going to be very minorly, you know, maybe not punished, you know, anything or anything. Just very, very light, very light. The day is going to pass very light with it. And those who are taking their book with their left hand, okay, those are gonna be in deep trouble. And sometimes they say it's hide it in their back, okay,
yes.
Or from their back. It's not really, they are not gonna get it from their back. They're gonna take it from their left hand, but because of the shame in it, okay, and the bad things in it, oh, they will hide it as if, you know, they don't want anybody to see it.
It's the main guy.
Okay. Other thing, لا يوجد حكم غيابي. There is no actually verdict. Okay, here you can go to the court. Okay, and if you're not there, if you are the defendant and you're not there, the judge can set his verdict. And you're not there. You don't know. You'll know later on from
his judgment.
Yeah, you know about his judgment or his verdict later on. Your lawyer is gonna tell you. Okay, But over there, right away, on the spot, you will know the verdict. Okay? وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون.
ياسين.
سورة ياسين. Okay? There is no appeal. There is no coming in another trial.
No appeal.
No appeal. That's it. لا يوجد نقد أو استئناف. No appeal. That's it.
Okay.
That's it. Only one day. Yes, sir.
So the books will be given either in the right hand or left hand.
It depends on.
It depends on. Yes. Maybe you get it in the left hand.
Hey, why?
No, my question is not yet. I'm coming to the question.
No, I mean it depends on your goodies. If you
okay,
read,
so there's. But so we already know that the book is coming either in the left hand or right hand.
You
right?
will be handed the book.
I know.
Either
I know. My question is, there is a surah called Surah Al-A'raf. People will be standing in the middle. For 500 years, right?
No, why 500? Yeah, no, 500 for the 50,000
years. You're going to be watching everything.
Now, and people will be holding the book in the right hand or left hand?
Who? Al-A'raf?
Yeah.
No, that's a good question.
Okay.
The people of the height. These people, their good deeds will be equal to their bad deeds. This is a different case completely. For these people, they will be in hall for 50,000 years until Allah will finish the judgment between people. And they're going to see all the scenario, everything. They will see the people of Jannah and they will see the people of hellfire. For 50,000 years, they're just in hall like this, in an area called the Al-A'raf. We have the chapter, Al-A'raf. Al-A'raf, the heights. That's like, they know the crown of the rooster.
The rooster.
Yes, it is in the top of the head of the rooster. That place, it will be in the top like this and you will see everything. They will see everything. But imagine you wait for 50,000 years. And this,
now, are these people holding the books in the left hand or right hand?
No, there is no left or right, but they are different case.
Yeah, but most probably...
They will be in hold, the books.
Most probably, Allah will forgive them after the 50,000 years. And that there
yes, but the question, Sheikh, your doctor, about...
I know.
Which hand they're going to receive, they will not receive anything. Because they will be in hold, you're a different case.
Okay.
Your book is going to be in hold too. Until Allah will finish from everybody, then... We'll look at you now. Your hasanat equal to your gisayat. Your hasanat is good, but he was a shaheed, but he was bad to his parents.
Right.
Put in hold. He has a lot of good deeds, but he owed people money. Hold. These people, they will be in different cases. There is no book for them. The book will be in hold too. Yeah. Put on it.
The next thing, لا يوجد شهود زور. There are no false people to testify. لا لا يوجد شهود زور. There is no false testimony. No witnesses. Just think about it. The court in here. Okay, you can pay somebody to come and give a testimony, and it probably has nothing to do with the court. But depends on how much you pay him, how good he will say. Okay. Against you or with you, depends on. But over there are no those. And God said, يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. And that day, their hands, their tongues, their legs will be the shuhud. Will be witness what you've done. Okay. So your own things are gonna testify with or against you, okay? And then next one, لا توجد ملفات منسية. There are no forgotten documents. All the documents needed are there. أحصاه الله ونسوه والله على كل شيء شهيد.
صراحة خطيرة يا دكتور. خطيرة.
Yes. There is no. You in this court, we forgot one document. Okay, give us some time, we can bring it so we can talk about it next time. Oh, there was one document, but we didn't really get a chance to look it up and study it, so the lawyers will ask for extension. Okay, no, there's nothing. Everything is going to be there.
Very good, important point. These documents will never be missed, but does not mean documents will be there. Allah will show your shame to others. No. There is something different here. The mu'min, Allah will put like a veil between him and people. And Allah will not show your shame to others. قَلْ سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْيَوْمَ أَغْفِرُهَا لَكَ ادْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ بَرَحْمَتِي. I covered you up during your lifetime. Today I will forgive you. Just go to Jannah by my mercy. Not everything in the book will be shown to the people. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, this is rahmah. But documents will be there. Nothing will be missing.
The last thing is, what is, it's not the last, there are so many who don't really know, but this is what I managed to get, okay? It is a mizan daqiq lil a'mal. It's really very fine scale, okay? Weighing your good deeds and bad deeds and exact justice by the microgram. Exact misqal al-zaratin, okay? وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ God will set the scale, a just one, okay? فلا تظلم نفس شيئا. Nobody will be treated unjustly. Okay. وإن كان مثقال حبة خردل أتينا بها
من
خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين. Okay. Even if it's small grain or you know خردل is like a grain of something. Okay. Even that it would be accounted for. Okay. And this is Surah Al-Anbiya, verse 47. Okay, so this is what we're gonna be waiting for, what we're gonna be facing, and it's all good, okay? But the criteria is, you have to make it good. You really, because this is your deed in here, what you are doing right here, is what you're gonna see there. So you wanna see good things there, you wanna be happy there, you wanna be cheerful there, prepare for it, okay? Make good deeds, make hasanat, so you can go there and you are really comfortable and God will, inshallah, protect us. Inshallah, will protect Ameen. All of us. Inshallah. Ameen. We have to do for this one. We have to plan for this great day. But when you stand behind, in front of Allah, between His hands, and He's talking to you, okay? And inshallah, He will say, "Ishabu ya ibadi, qad ghafartu lakum." Inshallah.
Ameen. If I have a choice, I like what the doctor said, mashallah. This is exactly what the Quran said, and this is what we know. If somebody asks you, which one is better, the court of dunya or the court of al-akhirah? Even it's so difficult, you cannot escape, you cannot go anywhere. Your record of your good deeds will be in your hand. Malaika will guard you and can drive you to the land of gathering. And all of this stuff, which, if you have a choice, between two courts, the court like the court of dunya, this is our court here, or the court of al-akhirah. Which one is bitter? Al-akhirah, right?
Why?
Because this court is a kharban.
Because who's gonna judge you is Allah.
Yes.
Okay. And the continuation to what the doctor said. Now, I mean, one time they asked Ali ibn Abi Talib. Okay. في يوم القيامة من تحب أن يحاسبك الله ولا والديك؟ If your parents would you like your parents to judge you or Allah? He said Allah of course. Why? Because Allah is more rahim.
Exactly.
He is more justice. Is more kind than my parents. My parents will judge you. You really with everything. I mean, we do things here. We are ashamed to tell our parents about it. But Allah yasturna fi.
Yes.
Okay. So Allah is more rahim, Allah more kind. I would have him, of course, to judge me.
Much came to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, who will judge me in the day of judgment? He said, Allah will judge you. Because Allah is Rahim. Allah is Rahim. This court will never scare you, but be careful, but
prepare
for it. Do you know why? Because when we read this and the Quran saying, He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so just. In His court, nobody will be oppressed. There is no oppression there. Yeah. That's why He will count you with little zarra, like weight of matter, you know. That's why, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, but in general, His rahmah is still there. 100 mercy waiting for you there. Yeah. Somehow, inshallah, we'll get some kind of forgiveness and there.
Yes.
Yeah. So we extract our religion of Islam is the religion of justice, but not equality.
No,
justice. The religion of just, not equality. Because Some will be punished, and some will get into inshallah Jannah. And each and everyone, after the judgment, will feel content about the verdict. Whoever is going to Jahannam, he will have no complaint because he knew
and
he did whatever he did, because that's why he's getting. So no upper court or ninth circuit, nothing. And that person who is going to Jannah, alhamdulillah.
But in this court, in this court, would you like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deal with you with his justice
or
this,
with, deeds,
or with his rahmah?
Rahmah.
Fadl and rahmah. Rahmah. قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا وخير مما يجمعون. With rahmah is a mercy. Like, don't make like that Israeli guy who worshipped Allah 500 years. And Allah said, oh, take him to the Jannah, to the angel. Because he because out of my mercy, take him to the Jannah.
Oh, yeah.
And they said, no, not because of your mercy. Yeah, I've been working for 500 years in praying, doing all good deeds.
So it was my deeds.
My deeds.
Deserve to go.
Yes, exactly. Skharbar, come on, bring him back to the court. Just get one of his eyes. Sight. Ni'mah. This is one of Allah's bounties.
Listen,
give it to him. Yes, put it in the scale. And what happened? Nothing. Nothing. His deeds, nothing. 500 deeds. Say, go to him, fight. Because of your good deeds, God will find. And he said, I'm sorry, no. Start apologizing again. I'm sorry, Ya Rabbi. And subhanAllah, said again, not to Jannah.
So, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala judge us based on justice, then nobody will go to.
We'll be in big trouble.
Big trouble.
If we go to Jannah,
nobody will go.
Not because of our deeds.
Exactly. Because of His rahmah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Doctor, you gave the, as if the whole picture we could envision, like how is the court set, like you give bit by bit. Thank you so much. We can.
Yeah, I have a question here.
Now we have to work on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have a question.
You know, just came from Bangladesh.
I see the whole thing.
Yeah.
I mean, at the end, the mercy, the bowl.
Yes.
That we have, because Allah is Rahman, Rahim, Kareem, and all of those things.
Yes.
But at the same time, through Quran we know Allah is only sent, total wise, total knowledgeable. I mean, which is, we can see, we don't see, but we have in our heart, everything. I mean, so He knows, I mean, forget about atoms, even part of atoms, He knows everything.
And more than that,
Quran, we know Allah is just.
Yeah.
He's so much so just. Even those people to the go to the hell, they will say, yes, Allah is just. I did these things, and I deserve these things, so
yes.
I am in hell.
Whatever.
Yes. So, and people in Jannah, if we need just, there's no way we can go without the mercy.
Yes.
So this is the scary part. I mean, who gonna get Allah's rahmah? And who is not gonna get Allah's
rahmah? Us, inshallah. We'll get it, inshallah.
That's the scary part.
You'll get it. Do you know why you're gonna get it? Do you know why you're gonna get it? The mercy of Allah? You will get it, inshallah. Do you know why? Because you deserve it. Do you know why you deserve it? Because you are already here in Salat al-Fajr. Not anybody in Salat al-Fajr. Yes, this is a sign. You are here. You are here. Everybody's sleeping. You're coming. You're standing. I'm coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He called me. I get a call. I can answer. His call. That's why you are here. You deserve it. Those who deserve the rahmat of Allah, those who used to obey Him. Yes. Bishwad is coming from Calabasas. From where?
Valencia.
From Valencia. Like Calabasas is very close. From Valencia. Why he's coming here? All 17 masjid in his way. SubhanAllah, see? This is somebody who will deserve Allah's mercy. That's why He will grant them His mercy, subhanAllah. Because they did for that.
I have a little advice to all of us. It not might not be related to what's a nice thing to go by it.
Yeah.
It says, I'm going to say it in Arabic and then I'm going to translate it. كل يوم تعيشه هو هدية من الله. Every day you live, when you wake up, you find yourself alive, this is a gift from
Allah.
Okay. So, فلا تضيعه بالقلق من المستقبل. Don't waste that happiness of that day, of that gift. How are you gonna waste it? Oh, you're gonna be, what's gonna happen tomorrow? I'm worried about tomorrow, okay? Or I am really regretting what happened in the past. Just live the day, don't think of the past, or don't predict what's gonna be happening in the future, okay? All what you're gonna say, Alhamdulillah, watawakkal ala Allah, and live the day. Yeah. Every day is like that, you're gonna be always in heaven.
The scholar also, doctor, they said, don't worry about tomorrow. And don't even ask Allah for your rizq for tomorrow. Why? Because if you die today, He will not ask you about your prayer for tomorrow. But don't ask Him for your rizq for tomorrow. Ask Him for today. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. Before we finish, doctor, JazakAllah khair. Make dua for brother. We have three brothers. They need your dua. Brother Muhammad Bitar, but he will be okay, inshallah.
He's okay, but he's still in.
Brother Samir Kamoun. Samir Kamoun, he's gonna make like surgery in his heart after 1 week.
Oh.
Yes. He called me yesterday. You know Samir Kamoun, Charlie. Yes. And the brother Sabri is in the hospital also. He has pain in his chest. His wife just texts me for Fajr.
Oh.
Yeah, if I make dua for them, inshallah.
Sabri?
Yeah.
Father.
Father.
اللهم نجاعتك
آمين
يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظم سلطانك
آمين.
يا أكرم الأكرمين يا أجود الأجودين يا كريم يا حليم يا عليم
آمين.
لك الحمد أنت ملك السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد كل الحمد فأنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد أنت الحق وقولك حق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والجنة حق والنار حق والنبيون حق ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق والساعة حق لك الحمد بالإيمان لك الحمد بالقرآن لك الحمد بالإسلام اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبك المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وصل وسلم وبارك عليه في الأولين وصل وسلم وبارك عليه في الآخرين وصل وسلم عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم احشرنا مع رسولك الكريم في جنة الفردوس العليا ومتعنا به وفرحه بنا فقد آمنا به ولم نره في هذه الدنيا فلا تحرمنا لقاءه ورؤيته في الآخرة اللهم اجعلنا من أوليائك وأوليائك لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون واجعلنا من جنودك فجنودك هم المنصورون يا الله يا عال يا متعال يا وكيل يا أحد يا صمد قد قلت في كلامك العظيم وقرآنك الكريم ادعوني استجب لكم فنحن ندعوك ونتذلل لك ولوجهك الكريم ان ترضى عنا وتغفر لنا وتعفو عنا فانك عفو كريم حليم غفور رحيم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اجعلنا ممن قلت فيهم لملائكتك اشهدكم يا ملائكتي اني غفرت لهم
اللهم اغفر
لهم اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من احبك وحب عمل يقربنا الى حبك اللهم ارزقنا مما نحب فاجعله قوة لنا فيما تحب.
أمين.
اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات.
أجمعين.
اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات. واعف عنا وارحمنا وبارك لنا وزد في رزقنا وبارك لنا في رزقنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لي اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي وارحمهما. كما ربياني صغيرة ولكل من له حق علينا يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا لا إله إلا الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم
الحمد لله جزاكم خيرا.